I'm anxious the whole time, mind you. I have anxiety the whole time. And I got a letter on my door that was saying, like, hey, it's gonna go to court. I literally manifested this whole situation. I have a story to tell y'all. All right, guys, I'm so excited for this video. Like, you don't even understand. I am in my new car, my Toyota Camry TRD with the red interior 2021. And I'm so excited, I'm so grateful, I'm so proud of this car. This car means so much to me. His name is De Niro. The story of how I got this car was crazy. I hope that this story just inspires somebody to believe in yourself, to speak up for yourself, to put your foot down, to decide what you want and to go for it. And also just to believe that anything is possible, for real, because this is crazy. And honestly, if you believe that, like, thoughts are things and that you have the power to manifest the things that you want into your life, I hope this story just really inspires you that, like, yeah, that's so true. So let's take it all the way back, right? We're gonna take this all the way back to earlier this year. My sister got a new car, my mom got a new car, my stepdad got a new car. I'm the only one who didn't get a new car. I was driving a 2010 Ford Escape at 170,000 miles. That was my baby. I was driving that thing till the wheels fell off, literally. And my mom kept saying, oh, you should go ahead and get a new car, you get a new car. And I feel like she was just saying that because everybody else got a new car, but I just didn't want to. Like, I was like, I don't need something new, so why get something new? You know, like, why do I need something new when I can keep driving the Escape? And I also, too, my mom pointed this out to me too. I like to get what I want and take care of it, and things grow sentimental value to me, especially over time. You know, I'm not the type of person who wants to swap out a car every year. Some people do that, you know. Some people like to lease a car because that way they can switch cars whenever they want. That's not me. I want to buy what I want. I want it to be mine, and I'm going to keep it for as long as I can and take really good care of it. That's how I've always been my whole life. My mom pointed that out to me when I got this car, because it'll make sense with the story. But so I didn't want a new car. I wanted to keep my Escape. I was cool with my Escape. However, recently, you know, I was like, okay, well, my business is doing really well and we need to spend some money because we need stuff to write off for taxes. So I was like, okay, so maybe I will get a new car, you know? And so I was looking at getting a Toyota 4Runner. Key part, Toyota. So I was looking at getting a Toyota 4Runner because I was like, oh, if I have to take packages to the post office, because at that time, if you guys don't know me or you're new, I have a candle business called Ardent Candle. We make scented candles. Went really viral this year on TikTok and, like, blew up. If you've ever seen the cereal candles on TikTok, that's me. Well, my business, we're like, okay, we need to spend money. And if I'm taking packages to the post office, because I was taking 1 to 2 trips every single day to the post office to drop off packages. So I was like, okay, if I'm going to be taking packages to the post office, I need to get a truck. Like, I need to get a car that has space. You know what I'm saying? So I was looking at the Toyota 4Runners because I really like that truck. But then we started shipping with UPS, and UPS picks up from us twice a day, so we don't ever have to take any packages to the post office anymore. So I was like, okay, if I don't need to take packages to the post office, then I don't need a truck anymore. Like, I can get a car and I'll be fine. So what kind of car should I get, right? I can get something nicer now. So I really, really, really like the Mercedes AMG GLE 63 Coupe. Now, I had never liked Mercedes. I was not a Mercedes fan. But after I saw that coupe, it was parked outside of my apartment one day, and I was like, whoa, I really like this a lot. So that was the car I wanted, right? Before I decided I wanted the AMG GLE Coupe, I made my vision board for 2022, like, months ago, because I had already achieved everything that was on my vision board for 2021 back in May. So in, like, August, I made my new vision board, right? We started shipping with UPS in, like, September or October. And so I was like, okay, well, I don't need a big truck anymore. I can get something nicer. So I was looking at the Mercedes, but the Toyota was on my vision board. Remember that. The Toyota is on my vision board, right? So I'm like, okay, cool. Yeah, I want to get a Mercedes. I was planning on buying Mercedes towards the end of next year. However, remember, there was a Toyota on my vision board. Well, the transmission went out on my Escape. My old Escape, the transmission went out. My mom was saying, when the transmission goes out, you might as well go ahead and get another car. Once you start having problems with your transmission, with your engine, that stuff costs thousands of dollars to fix. So don't keep investing money into this old vehicle when you could be putting that same money into a new vehicle. And so that's when I was like, okay, now I have to get a new car. And I need one now. So, you know, I wanted the Mercedes, but I need a car now. And I can't afford a Mercedes right now. And then I was also too, I'm like, I don't want the expenses that come with owning a Mercedes, right? If something happens to this car, it's not too pricey to fix. Something happens to a Mercedes, it's very expensive to fix, you know? And I was like, I don't want to deal with that. So what other cars do I like? Just thinking about it, and I'm like, oh my God, I remember riding in a Camry with my sister, because my sister wants the same car that I have. I remember, like, months ago, like probably in April, we went to go test drive cars, and we went to go test drive the Camry, and I remember being like, whoa, this is really nice. And so I was like, maybe I'll check out the Toyota Camry. So I go to a Toyota dealership. I test drive when I'm like, oh my God, I really like this car. Like, I really like this car. But I like the XSE. Now, I ended up getting a TRD, which is even a level up from there because it has a TRD package. But I was like, I really like the XSE, right? So now I'm watching videos on TikTok. I'm watching videos on YouTube of the car and I'm getting really inspired. And so I'm seeing the car. I'm seeing like, oh yeah, I'm just trying to make sure this is the car I really want. And this one specifically that I'm sitting in right now is the exact one that I really wanted. Now, there's a car shortage and there's such a high demand for this exact one that I have. The two-tone Toyota Camry, the white Toyota with the black roof, the panoramic sunroof, and the red interior. This is extremely limited right now because there's such high demand for it, and with the car shortage, it's like impossible to get one of these. Like, if you want to get one of these new, you would literally have to wait till 2022. It would literally be 12 months before you can even get one of these new, right? But this is where it gets so good. So I'm looking at the Toyota Camry. I'm like, this is the one I want. I'm watching videos on TikTok. I'm like, yes, I want the red interior. I want the white car with the black roof. Like, this is the one I want right now. Remember, I told you it's very limited. So I talked to my business partner. I'm like, hey, my transmission on my car went out. He's like, okay, cool. We can buy you a new car. We can buy it in the company's name. My business would buy the car completely cash, and then it would be a write-off, but it would technically be the company's car. It's like, let's say something happened to my business. The business could have to give up the car or sell the car, or if we got sued, my car would be on the line because it's not Kobe's car, it's Ardent Candle's car. And then I'll also have to put an Ardent Candle sticker on my car, right? So that was the option, right? But we were looking at SE, and this was before I decided I wanted a XSE, right? The SEs are like $28,000. We can do that cash. We can't do $40,000 cash, which was what my car was, 42, which is, it was supposed to be 47. But I'm telling you, everything just works out so perfectly. So November 28th, I'm in the car with my mom and my sister, and we're calling all the Toyota dealers, and we're driving around to different Toyota dealers. Nobody has an XSE. They have SEs, but I didn't want the SE. I wanted the XSE. Nobody has an XSE. Nobody. Nobody has a new one. They have one that has like 14,000 miles, 30,000 miles, but nobody has a new one. They said the soonest they'll have new XSEs is February, but I need a car right now because my car broke down. So I'm like, oh, dang, they don't have one. So my mom's like, oh, let's try CarMax. So we go to CarMax, right? And my mom calls them before we get there, and they're like, yeah, we have two XSEs, and all the cars at CarMax are used. So I wasn't really looking forward to like checking CarMax because I'm like, I want a new car. Well, we call them, we ask them, do they have an XSE? They say, yeah, we have two XSEs. I'm like, okay, we can go check them out. They said one has 3,000 miles, one has 5,000 miles. That's basically new. A car is technically in Virginia considered a new car if it's under 7,500 miles. Like, literally, this car that I have right now, the owner probably got it, drove it around for like a month, and turned it in. Like, this car is basically new. There's still the plastic wrap on the thing, on the little handle in the trunk. Like, I'm talking, this car is basically new, right? Which is crazy because I wanted a new car and it's basically new, you know what I'm saying? So we get to the dealer, right? Now, this is where it gets crazy. So we get to the dealer and I'm like, hey, we wanted to come and check out your Toyota Camrys. And they were like, okay, do you have an appointment? So we were like, no. So he was like, okay, well, we can put you on the wait list. So I'm like, okay. He was like, in the meantime, though, you can go look around. That was so perfect because if we didn't get to look around, I probably would not have found this car and found it the way I did to where I got a discount on it. I'm telling you, everything works out, bro. You just got to know what you want and believe that you can have it. We're like, okay, cool. So we're looking around. I see this car. I'm like, I don't know what this is, but this is the one. This is what I want. This is exactly what I want. This is exactly the one I saw on TikTok. This is a car that I want, period. If they have this available, I want this. Now, mind you, there was a sticker on the window that said this car is not for sale. So I'm like, oh, dang. I don't know why this car is saying it's not for sale, but I really want it. And in hindsight, it almost feels like that sticker was on the car to reserve it for me, like so that nobody else will buy it. And I'm gonna explain why. So we're looking around at cars, but I'm like, this is the one. They call me and they're like, hey, you're next up on the wait list. I heard you wanted to test drive cars. I was like, well, I just wanted to see your Toyota Camrys, but there's a Toyota Camry TRD outside that I really, really like. And they're like, we don't have any TRDs. She's looking up in the system. She's like, we don't have any TRDs. So I'm like, well, I'm standing right in front of it. She's like, okay, I'll come out there, I'll check. But in my system, there's no TRDs. She goes out there And she's like, oh yeah, there is a TRD. They put it in as a XSE. And so the sticker in the window said XSE, and it had the $42,000 price tag instead of the $47,000 price tag that the TRD was supposed to be, because somebody there put in the wrong price. So she's like, oh, I'm so sorry. I went out there, the car is out there. Someone put it in our system as the wrong car, but because the sticker on the window said the XSE price, I have to honor the XSE price today. And I said, okay, well, there was a sticker on the window that said it's not for sale. Is it available? She's like, oh yes, I can sell it to you. She said the only reason that sticker is on the window is because we hadn't got pictures of it yet to put on the website to make it available. And how was it that it happened to be the day I get there that this car, like, you know, it's crazy. It's so crazy. So I'm like, wow. It's almost like this car was literally sitting here waiting for me. And it's wild too, because we checked all these stores and nobody had it. And all of a sudden my mom's like, let's check the used car store. And they have the exact car I want. And then because it's used, but it's basically new, but because there was a previous owner, I didn't have to pay all the new car fees. Yo, when I tell you, it's crazy. Everything always works out, but I'm telling you, you just gotta know what you want, clearly know what you want, and believe that you deserve it and you're gonna get it. And I'm telling you, you will get it. So now I'm like, oh shoot, I might actually be able to get this car. So we go in and we sit down. We're trying to figure out the whole, you know, car situation, how I can get the car. This is my first time buying a car. So I was like so glad my mom was there, because I didn't know what I was doing. So my mom was there and the lady was super helpful. If you guys are looking for a car, go to the CarMax on Bonnie Road in Virginia Beach. CarMax in Virginia Beach and ask for Lindsay. She is the best. She will explain everything to you. She's great. Especially if it's your first time, Lindsay is the one, okay? We got there at noon and we didn't leave there till like 6 p.m. But it was so worth it. I learned so much about buying a car and the whole process, and Lindsay was walking me through literally everything. So I call my business partner and I'm like, hey, they have a car here. It's exactly the one I want, down to every detail. It's a TRD and it's $42,000. So he's like, oh, 42? He's like, we can't do 42. Like, we can't swing 42 right now. So I'm like, okay. He's like, you know, the cars we were looking at were like 30. So we could do that, but we can't do 42. So I'm like, okay, well, this is the one I want. And so he's like, they're overcharging for that, because he went on the website, looked at a brand new one, it's like 35, but also a brand new one, you can't get it until next year. They can charge more because it's scarce, you know, you can't get it. So he's like, yeah, you're gonna be paying way over for that car. You can get something else. Like, he starts sending me XSEs that are gonna be available next week at this one store, but I'm like, I don't want that. This is what I want. This is exactly what I want. And he's like, oh, it doesn't make sense. It's not a smart decision. I don't think you should get the car. Look, I'm not trying to lead you wrong, you know. And I'm like, look, I know you're not trying to lead me wrong. I trust you, you know what I'm saying? But the financial aspects of this that matter to you don't matter to me like that. What matters to me the most is me getting what I really want, you know, because he was saying like, oh, if you go to try to trade this car in for a new car later on, you're going to get screwed, which is true. It's true. But I'm not the type of person that's trading this car in. I'm probably going to have this car forever. You know what I'm saying? As long as it lasts. And that's how I was with the last car. You know, my mom really helped me, like, realize and remember, like, Kobe, you're not that guy who's trying to switch out his car every 2 years. You know, you're the type of person who, when you have things, when you buy things, they have sentimental value, you know, and so you hang on to it, you know, and you cherish it, and you take care of it. And I was like, you know what, you're so right. And she was like, you know, your great grandmother was the same way. She was not going to get just anything. She was going to get what she wanted. And when she got it, she took great care of it, but she was not going to settle for nothing. You know, that's how she was. And that's exactly the same way I have literally been all my life, you know. And he just kept trying to tell me like, oh, I actually have the text. He just kept trying to tell me like, oh, you shouldn't get it. This doesn't make sense. I'm telling you right now, I mean, you're a grown man, so you make your own decisions, but this is not a good decision. This is not a smart decision, because you're going to be paying way over, and there's a brand new one next week that's only cost 30. It was an XSE, though. It only cost 30. We could swing that, but I'm just trying to tell him, I'm like, you don't understand. And then he also brought up too, like, oh, just think, put it this way. Here's a new perspective for you. For every $1,000 you borrow, it's X amount of dollars a month that's going, you know, that you're going to be paying. Once again, it's about money. For me, that's not the priority. I want to be able to splurge on this if this is what I really want, you know? And my mom broke it down. She said the same way he won't stay in anything below a 4-star hotel. He just chooses to splurge on the hotel. I choose to splurge on my car. But he kept saying that. And now, this is where the big breakthrough for me came. Because for so long, I've had the hardest time speaking up for myself. And it stems back to stuff that happened when I was a kid, a little kid, you know? And it carried on with me throughout my adulthood, and I just realized it at the end of last year, and I started to work on it. You know, I got to the root of it, figured out where it came from. I, you know, had the conversations with my family to say, hey, look, remember when this happened? This is how it made me feel, and this is how it's affecting me as an adult today. And we were able to talk about it and you know, all that good stuff. And I was able to move on, and now I've been working on it. You know, it's uncomfortable, but growth is uncomfortable, but it's worth it, you know? And so, you know, that's what my sister was telling me, like, you just have to practice speaking up for yourself now. That's the only way it's gonna get better, because the more you do it, the more comfortable you're gonna get with it. And the more you do it successfully, the more you're gonna have trust and believe in yourself that I can do this, and I'm gonna speak up for what I want, you know? And this was really a testing moment for me. It was really a testing moment for me, right? Because here I am, I'm anxious the whole time, mind you, I have anxiety the whole time. I mean, like, I'm literally shaking, you know? Because it's so uncomfortable for me to speak up for myself, right? But I have to keep practicing it if I wanna get better at it, and if I don't want this to be uncomfortable for me anymore, right? And if I really want this, I was like, this is literally my test. I need to speak up for myself. So he kept telling me not to get it, but I ultimately was like, no, this is what I want, so I'm gonna go ahead and get it. And he's like, okay, well, you know, it's not a smart decision, it doesn't make sense, blah, 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 blah. But I'm like, I'm fine with that. I am 100% okay with that. It's not about the money for me. This is about way more than the money for me. So I feel like at that moment, I passed the test. When I just put my foot down, I said, I'm getting this car. Now, I'm like, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get approved for it. I don't know if they're gonna need proof of income, because I'm self-employed. So that is like, it's really hard if you're self-employed to do like proof of income, because your income fluctuates, right? Because you have a business versus if you got a consistent paycheck every 2 weeks. So I'm like, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get approved or whatever. But here's how all this worked together so perfectly in my favor, right? So back in, nobody knows this for real, YouTubers, y'all are the first time hearing this, but back in August, I basically spent my rent money to buy my newest dog, Euro, my puppy. I just knew I was supposed to. It's hard to explain, and that's why I haven't told this to anybody, but yeah, I spent my rent money on my dog, and I think this was August. I wasn't able to pay rent on time, and I got a letter on my door that was saying like, hey, you forgot to pay your rent. If you don't pay it by this date, it's gonna go to court and blah, 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 blah. And I'm gonna make a whole story about how I manifested Euro too, and Penny, both my dogs, because the story how I got them is crazy too. But I knew I was supposed to get Euro. I had to figure it out. I knew I was supposed to get him, and that story was crazy, right? But me getting him and being in that situation where that letter came to my door, right? Something clicked in me where I said, okay, I need to get better with my money. I need to get better with my money, because I'm making a whole lot of money, but I'm broke because I just kept spending it. I just kept spending it because I never had that much money before. I've never had this much money before. You know what I'm saying? That I make now. I never had this much before. But so I kept making all this money. I was just spending it. I was very irresponsible with it. That's the thing. If you don't know how to handle your money when you got $10, you don't know how to handle your money when you got $1 million. You don't. You're not going to. And you're going to lose it. I'm telling y'all from experience. And luckily, I wasn't spending my business money. I was very disciplined about, I don't touch my business's money. I take a salary out of my business and that's it, right? Because I didn't want to end up spending all my business money and then my business have to shut down because, oh, I spent all the money, you know? So I was very strict about that, which I'm so glad. I'm so grateful to have my business partner who kind of held me accountable just to make sure that I wasn't dipping into my business's bank account, right? That's something I'm so grateful for. So when I got Euro and I was in that situation, that made me get serious about my money. So I got real serious about saving. And guess what? I was able to put the down payment on my car. Crazy, right? I got so serious about saving because of that Euro situation that led me to be in this position where I can make the down payment on my car and get the car that I really want. Okay? And then around that same time, I was like, you know what? I'm trying to buy a house eventually. I'm gonna have to buy a car eventually. I need to start getting my credit together too. So I started working on my credit, right? And little by little, my credit score keeps improving to where now we put in an application for this car. Guess what? I got approved instantly. They didn't need no verification, no further documentation, nothing, because my credit score was high enough. And I'm just like, it's so crazy how all of this has led me to this moment where I found the exact car that I wanted and I was able to get it. And so me getting this car is so much bigger to me than just a car, because this was a test for me to speak up for myself again. Because, oh yeah, after I drove off the lot with this car, you don't understand, I had a whole new level of belief in myself to where I'm like, oh yeah, I'm not about to silence myself for the stuff that I want for nobody. No, I'm speaking up. I spoke up to get this car, and every time I look at this car, I see strength. Every time I get in this car, I see strength. Kobe, you did that. You, as anxious as you were and as scared as you were, put your foot down, and now you got your car. The exact car that you wanted, bro. So this car means so much more to me than just a vehicle. That, oh, I got the cool Toyota with the red interior and the panoramic sunroof. No, this car means so much to me because every time I look at this car, every time I get in this car, every time I sit in this car, every time I look at my key, every time I look at my car keys, I just see strength. And I'm so proud of myself that, like, Kobe, you fought through everything that you were dealing with inside and stood up for yourself and put your foot down and got your car. The exact car that you wanted. Every detail. And you manifested this car because, remember, Toyota was on my vision board. Right? And then this was the exact one that I visualized in my head. I saw it because I was watching TikToks. It's the exact one that I wanted. Mind you, this car was not available. You cannot get this car. You know, if you want to get this car, it's going to take at least 12 months because it was in such high demand. So many people have it. How is it that I ended up finding a used one that's basically new, that had a sticker on it that said it's not for sale, but I bought it for a discounted price at that? So I literally manifested this whole situation where I got the exact car that I saw in my mind. Right? So this car is proof that I am a powerful manifester, and that's one of my affirmations now. I am a powerful manifester, bro. If I want it, I got it. In due time, I got it. If I want it, it's gonna come. It's gonna come. And I'm gonna keep working hard and following my intuition and doing all the things that lead me up to this point where I can have the things that I want. But if I want it, oh, I got it. This car is living proof. This car is living proof. And so every time I just see strength. I see power. It reminds me that I can manifest anything. If I can manifest this car and that whole situation that played out so perfectly for me the way it did, nothing's off limits. Nothing's off limits. And I can do this. And then this car is going to help me build my credit score because now I have a new form of credit that I'm going to be paying off. And this car is also, just feel a level of maturity. Like, I'm growing, right? I bought this car in my name. I bought this car with my money, not my business. Yeah, my business is still my business, but it feels different when I bought it. This car is in Kobe Lomax's name. It just feels different. I'm on my own insurance now. I just feel like it was such a big moment. This whole experience getting this car was such a huge moment, life moment for me that I will never forget. And I don't know, every time I look at this car, I get in this car, I see this car, I just feel power and so proud. And it's just a reminder that, like, Kobe, you can do anything. That's really what this car means to me. And that's why I named this car. I never named my Escape, but I named this car like one of my own kids. You know what I'm saying? Like Penny, Euro, and Dinero. Because this car just means so, so much to me. So I hope that this story could inspire somebody. Let me know down below if you guys had any awakenings or any epiphanies, aha moments, or if this inspired you, or if you have a manifestation story that's really interesting or really cool that could inspire somebody else. Because I'm telling you, man, I couldn't wait to tell this story, and I'm so proud of myself. I'm so excited, and I just love this car so much. Yeah, I just couldn't wait to tell this story, and I really hope that it inspires somebody, because it was quite the journey getting here, but we're here. And once again, it just proves to me that, like, Kobe, you can do anything. It's nothing you can't do. It's nothing off limits, you know? And I'm excited to see what I do next. Next year, I want to buy a house. So we will definitely see. I got to go make a new vision board. And I'm going to make a vision board video too. Tell y'all all about that and how you can start creating a vision board and manifest. You say, I almost feel like y'all's big brother. Like, I'm just giving y'all all the game on, like, how to win in life. But I have learned a lot. Like, I know I'm young, but I have been through a lot and I've learned a lot in my short 22 years, about to be 23 years of living. And so I'm just so excited and, like, proud to share the things I've learned with you so that you can take whatever you need for you and do it. But thank you so much for watching. Like I said, I hope this video was inspiring. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're looking forward to more videos like this, then be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you don't miss an upload. If you're not following me on Instagram or TikTok, you can follow me there at Kobe Lomax. And if you want to see the actual car, like the whole car and all the bells and whistles and whatnot, I uploaded a video yesterday giving you guys the car tour, so you can check that video out right here. And yeah, I'm just so excited, so proud. Thank you so much, so much for watching, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Now I'm bringing that Christmas cheer, like, deck the halls for Santa Claus, la 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 la. Snow is falling, fire's on, la 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 la.